Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to It's Obvious Gaming. My name's Garrett Drake, and I'm joined alongside Jacob Alka and Preston Pugh. We make video game videos for gamers by gamers, because that's who we are, and that's who we care about.
Video game videos.
Boys, it's always a pleasure to be with you here playing games every Sunday night for the last 33 weeks, I believe. We've been doing this video game channel, and here
that's
we are.
Awesome.
Yeah, it's been a long time. Here we are playing Assassin's Creed Syndicate for the second time. Preston, let us know how you progressed since our last video in this video game here.
I didn't progress a lot.
You've unlocked some new abilities.
I've unlocked some new abilities, played a few missions, assassinated a few, if you will.
Okay.
I really hope you showcase those new abilities for me.
We'll see. I'll probably.
Because I haven't really seen any of this game yet.
Somehow. I'm partaking right now on a story mission for Jacob. As the story goes on, Jacob and Ellie do different. Jacob and Evie do kind of different things. Evie is on the hunt for a piece of Eden, while Jacob is just wanting to grow his gang.
Oh, so sounds like he's the loser of the family.
Yeah, you could say that.
It's his twin sister. Yes, who's older by the minutes and seconds here?
I don't think they've told me yet.
Okay.
Well, that's important.
Well, clearly she has the bigger goal in mind.
Yeah, I feel like maybe she would be the
I feel
older.
Like her story's a little more exciting, but I don't know. Recruiting a gang could be kind of fun.
So you're recruiting a gang specifically, specifically for the reason of taking out Templars, or is it a different goal?
Yeah. There's a Templar in charge. His name starts with an S.
Mm-hmm.
Forgot it.
Sebastian.
Salamander.
Yes, Salamander.
Salvador.
Sebastian.
Salvador.
Okay. Salvador. Salamander.
This is a
Sebastian.
Very cool shot right here.
Yeah, I do like this.
That looks
this
awesome.
Is the smoke in the back.
I recall the first screenshot I ever saw for this game was Jacob on a rooftop overlooking factories like that, and it was really cool.
Yeah, it definitely looks more dark and gritty than a typical Assassin's Creed that we played.
I like all the wet roads too. Looks cool.
So, assuming
just run that guy over,
take
this
guy out.
Out of my way, swine.
So far from what you played, has this story intrigued you?
It's alright.
Yeah.
It's alright. It's the first Assassin's Creed game in a while where you don't like start out as not an assassin. Like you kind of just join during them assassinating.
That was kind of how Assassin's Creed 3 was too, right? Kind of worked your like you didn't start out as an assassin. You're just Native American.
I mean, that's
guy.
How basically every Assassin's Creed has worked, besides Brotherhood and Revelation.
Yeah.
So they kind of just plop you down in the middle of just stuff happening.
Oh crap. Goodness!
So, do they consider themselves assassins? Like, if they call themselves
assassins? Oh, no, yeah, they are definitely assassins, yes. Okay. They work alongside other assassins and an order and stuff.
So they have, like, a mentor, like, in other games?
As far as I can tell, there's a guy they were, like, from the very beginning, they were like, see, I did not even want to do that at all. I don't know how to get out. There's a guy that they were kind of taking orders from, and that's about it. I don't know if that's really their mentor.
Right.
I don't know what I'm supposed to be doing. It says to drive a particular thing, so I guess I'll drive this one.
Yeah.
Run, Roach. Now, have you utilized your gang in any way, shape, or form so far?
You can. You have recruits that are just kind of like chilling around, and you can get them to join you and stuff.
Yeah.
I haven't done that because I just don't think that's as fun. I kind of like being by myself, going around doing stuff. But you can upgrade your gangs. Like, I actually upgraded a gang ability to where people on the streets, like those red guys right there, they will not attack me they fear me. And that
was
an ability that I had leveled up. So you can kind of do stuff like that with your gang.
I was going to ask how your gang differs from, like, the assassins you recruit in the other games.
It's essentially just an extension of that.
Mm-hmm.
I think you can just get them to follow you around and help you out in combat and stuff. I've only participated in one gang war, which is just kind of what you would think it would be, just two gangs going at it. And that actually wasn't very fun. Because there were too many people fighting and nobody really cared about me. I didn't have to counter or anything. I just mashed square.
Yeah.
Which it seems like the combat is way more like physical. You know, you can use brass knuckles and stuff, so it's definitely cool. Yeah. But it doesn't feel as technical as the old ones. It's just kind of just like, oh, smash square,
yeah.
and then a bar comes up, and then you push it. Nobody ever attacks you at the same time. No
of
two
course.
People ever do. You can do, like, double kills and stuff by leaving two people, like, in a dazed state, which is kind of how you... They're like, which is kind of what the one of the main things new about this combat is that you can leave them in like this day state and like continue attacking other people.
Yeah. Something else new I saw watching you play earlier was that you can dodge bullets now by just pressing triangle.
Yeah, I mean, used to in like Assassin's Creed 3, you can dodge bullets and shoot something else at like or shoot a bullet at them and stuff.
It just seems like it's easier this time around.
Yeah, because it gives you a lot of time. It gives you a lot of time to counter. It gives you a lot of time to do a lot of stuff. So I have to destroy that. I have to kill
have to
that dude. Or, I'm assuming I have to blow it up, though, since it's explosives.
And how you digging that grappling hook?
I like it. Speeds things up a bit.
Mm-hmm.
If you see, like, an area that's, like, super far away, you can just, like,
zipline over?
Zipline on over.
Can you use it in combat?
No.
Mm.
Is
that upgradable at any time to use it in combat?
No.
Wow, that's surprising.
Yeah, you can't like grapple people over to your.
I mean, if it's taken them this long to not, they still can't figure out how to have multiple people attack you at once. I guess adding a grappling hook to combat is way too complicated.
They added the hallucinogen darts where you can like shoot a thing of fire and it'll send out a little shockwave, and
that's cool.
He will go kill people.
That is cool.
Typically, in the gang areas, if you kill that dude right there, they a lot of people get scared and leave, so it's pretty...
If you can, like, somehow get over there and get behind them,
that'll do.
Oh, there you go.
And I will retreat.
So since there are two characters in this game, what's like the main difference between the two?
Stealth and action. But I
kind
of read...
Jacob's more physical and...
Oh, yeah. But that's the thing, is, like, you don't have to. Like, I'll kind of dive into the skill tree real quick. I can also unlock stealth skills. So if I wanted Jacob to be stealthy, I could. But the thing is that these skills down here at the bottom, they are only Eevee. So only Eevee can get the skill of her being able to just stand still and turn invisible.
Yeah, so Jacob's the blue.
Yeah, Jacob can, bring the enemies near death much more rapidly. So they
That's
want
cool.
you to use them in these roles, but you...
Kind of
necessarily,
pushing you to play a certain
yeah, but
way.
You necessarily don't have to.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
So, could you play through the whole game just using one character? Or do you have to switch for story?
As far as it's for story, yes, because I'm in a Jacob mission right now, and I'm pretty sure I can't switch to Eevee. Yeah, I can't switch to Eevee. This is his mission, trying to progress his goals and stuff.
I like that.
Whereas Eevee is, like I said, going after a piece of Eden. So
right.
Looks like I'm in the clear. Everybody
looks like you're good.
Everybody left for some
reason.
Coast
is clear.
So
I like that, though. Kind of gives you a dual storytelling. Also, it forces you to kind of...
Yeah, and the characters are very likable. They kind of... This is a very lighthearted Assassin's Creed. Like, there's some serious issues going on like child labor... etc. Some like pretty nasty stuff going on, but they kind of tell it in like a lighthearted way.
Mm-hmm.
If you can really tell something like that in a lighthearted way.
Yeah.
But ignite the car. How
do I do that? Do you have any fire?
Do I have any fire? I guess that's
do
how
you carry fire?
They're likable for sure. They kind of joke around with each other a lot. Eevee's definitely tries to be the more serious one.
Mm-hmm.
Jacob's kind of like the comedy relief.
I can tell just by looking at her.
Yeah. I like Eevee, though. She's a good character.
Yeah.
I know I said that in our first impressions video, but, playing with her for a few hours, I was going to...
How's that for a taste?
Took care of business there.
Stock price plummeting already. You're hired. Oh, I have more business planned for us both. Drop a note to my secretary.
I like
to make
the characters' get up so far.
Yes.
I don't actually
yes.
work.
I will say, when I was editing our first video for this, I was skimming through some of the soundtrack on YouTube, and it really made me want to play it, just the music alone.
Yeah.
I always have loved the music in the Assassin's Creed games.
I assume you're going to wait to play this game like me.
Yes, I'm probably going to play it around Christmas, probably.
Same here, yeah. I'm just getting excited for Halo 5 right now.
Yep,
there's way less customization as opposed to Unity. There's only outfits you can do. Like, that's it.
See, I like that much better than Unity. I did not like all the options. That was way too much.
I like
for
options,
me.
But all of these look cool, so I'm cool with that. I'm all.
I know I've said
cool.
this before. I like my assassin to look like a certain way that he's designed. I don't want him to be have all these different options.
One thing I've never been able to do in all the Assassin's Creed games is like, oh, you unlocked all the costumes from the previous games. I'm like, as cool as that is, I just can't bring myself to wear them because it just feels so out of place.
I'll wear them like maybe when I'm free roaming like every once in a while, but I'll always go back to the original.
Mm-hmm.
Uh-oh, well, I seem to have gotten in a combat tussle.
And I meant to say to our viewers, this video is out on a Tuesday, and you're probably wondering, why are you playing this when Halo 5 just came out? Well, don't fret, because we have filmed that, and it is coming out in your very near future, so don't fret about that.
We are definitely very excited for that game.
Certainly.
I'm so excited to play that campaign.
I know, it's going to be awesome.
Oh my goodness. After that trailer with the Muse music, I've been so pumped ever since.
Yeah, it's going to be good. Preston, do you plan on playing this all week?
No.
Or are you gonna finally pick up that Xbox
Maybe.
One?
No, I'm not going to. Sorry, guys.
We're gonna miss you online.
Yeah, Halo. I don't know. Nothing's really convinced me to get an Xbox One yet. I know Halo's gonna be great and stuff, but I'm actually way more interested as to getting a gaming PC as of now than an Xbox One. So
really?
That'll be my next purchase. Yeah.
Wow.
I've already scoped out what I want, etc. So,
Halo 5 won't convince you that nothing will.
Well, I actually heard that there might be some plans for Halo 5 to come to PC.
Really?
Yeah, I did hear that.
Yeah, they said it would be very easy for them to do. So, not that I would really get it. Hang on, am I even going the right direction? No, I'm not.
No.
crap. But, back to Assassin's Creed.
Yeah.
Did I do that? This game is definitely the best one I've played in a long time. Like, it has a lot of cool stuff. I know I told you guys before the game started that when everything works, it's really cool. And by works, I mean there's no animation hiccups. There's nothing bad that happens. Like, in that last tussle I had, for some reason, I became out of the combat state. So it wouldn't let me counter anything, and that guy got a hit on me.
Right.
Which things like that happen frequently to me. Granted, I might be very unlucky, but there are just a lot of things happen in this game that shouldn't happen.
Right.
And it's just not that it's buggy because it's running way better and it isn't having, you know, near as many bugs as Unity had. But there's
that was a nightmare.
Like we always say in Assassin's Creed, it's still not there yet.
Right.
And I've given up hope.
Just
they're
that
not,
running sequence just then. You had
not,
to grab onto that light.
Yeah.
They're,
granted, I could have avoided that, honestly.
That shouldn't even be there.
It's just like. They need to switch. I know they want to give you like a weighty character movement.
Yeah.
But I feel like that is bringing the game down because everything just feels super slow. Everything feels clunky.
Mm-hmm.
Like I'll do for instance switching to stealth. It's not smooth. I don't feel like an assassin. I don't feel like, you know, for instance, let's talk about Metal Gear Solid 5 real quick.
Mm-hmm.
That game makes you really feel like a badass, like secret agent guy. Like, you know, you're crawling on your belly. You feel completely in control of Big Boss. You truly feel like a predator hunting prey.
Right.
Mm-hmm. In this game, you, like I said, when it works, you feel that way, but you know, on the other side of the coin, I sometimes feel like the AI is really shoddy sometimes, and they'll, you know, walk weird over to me, and they'll see me weird, and they'll see me and be like, oh, I guess it doesn't matter, this guy's infiltrating my headquarters, whatever, I'll just
and my friend's
around.
Dead in the corner.
Yeah, exactly. Or I'll want to go into cover, and I can't stick to it and stuff. It's just very, very shoddy, but like I said before I went on this little rant, when it works, it's super fun.
Right.
Because the Assassin's Creed always gets your environment, your setting done correctly, and this definitely looks awesome.
Yeah, like, I love seeing all that, all the chimneys and the smoke and stuff coming out.
That was a cool rooftop just back then, too.
Rooftop?
Yeah, roof. Sorry.
Wow.
I used to say... It's a northern thing. Rooftop.
Why don't you go have some dinner as well?
Dinner?
Yeah.
What's wrong with dinner?
It's supper.
No one says supper.
Down here in the South, it's supper.
Yeah, no. We don't actually say supper. Don't take us like those kind of people.
I had an actual family argument with my grandparents about that.
Dinner and supper?
Yeah.
You see, my grandparents up north say supper, though.
Oh, they do?
I've never said supper, though.
Yeah, my grandparents always call it supper, and I say dinner. I told you to make it a point. Yankee.
My schedule
was same thing with, I said, I'm going to go get a soda. And they're like, where did you come from? It's a Coke. No matter what it is, it's a Coke.
Yeah.
Well, they say pop too up north.
It's
pop.
Yeah,
soda pop.
I'll have a soda pop. They like kicked me out of the house.
Break your legs.
You
don't
what?
You ever say that again. Speaking of supper, you guys ready for that T-bell later?
Yeah, that sounds good.
Right, it's always the T-bell on Sundays, ladies and gentlemen. Comment in the video if you're having T-bell as well.
Our official, official sponsor of It's Obvious Gaming, Taco Bell.
So we have a deal.
That's the dream if that was actually a thing.
You're fortunate I like you.
I really like Red Bull. Miss Attaway. Red Bull's pretty good.
Another sponsor of ours.
I had a Red
Bull. We have lots of sponsors.
I had a Red Bull on our lunch break, I believe, at work last week, and it did nothing for me.
I can tell that girl's,
unfortunately.
That chick's a bad guy. She just giggled at me when I left. She's like,
she's probably like Cruella DeVille.
Maybe she just wants
Karen, I have no idea what's happening right now.
Okay, here's a question. I know Jack the Ripper's in the game, but it looks like he's been advertised as DLC. So has he not been mentioned at all in the story?
Nah.
Gosh, that sucks.
Bro. It's DLC. Yeah,
it'd have been so cool if he's one of the main story characters.
Well, there's Charles Darwin and Dickens.
Yeah.
I forgot his first name.
Dickens. It's Charles Dickens, isn't it?
Is it Charles Dickens?
I'm pretty sure.
Who's
it is.
Darwin? What's his first name?
Charles as
Charles
well.
It's not Charles.
They're both
Dickens.
Charles?
There's,
no.
Think of the three big Charles. There's Charles Darwin, Charles Dickens, and Charles Xavier, who's the best of them all.
Oh, yes. Sure.
Is that a trick question?
No.
Oh, since I'm in a mission.
Leader of the X-Men.
Well, maybe I can look at my progression log and see.
You know what I would have liked to seen?
What's up?
There's so many different depictions of Jack the Ripper throughout history, through books, movies, games, what have you. It'd be cool if they had a cool twist on Jack the Ripper and you kind of find out about Jack the Ripper and find out that he's almost a rogue assassin, but he's still killing bad people. But he's doing it in just very grotesque, dark ways. Like, he's just a really corrupt assassin that has, like, really serious issues. And then he, like, is very violent with his victims. But the twist is that he's actually been killing villains the entire time. And he becomes, like, an ally of some sort.
That'd be cool.
I guess they'd have to see, like, the people that have actually died from, Jack the Ripper.
Yeah, it is certainly not pleasant what he did.
Yeah, like,
to his
what if you
victims.
Were
if
like,
you ever want to know, listen to the Whitechapel song they wrote about Jack the Ripper. It is literally like anything you've ever heard in your entire life. It is quite
like,
violent.
I could totally see like people that were like related. Oh, well,
no,
I seem to have just dropped
up.
In the middle of everything. I'll free them anyways.
I think it's gonna let you.
It says not to kill. They don't. They seem like they literally don't care. So whatever.
So were they just alarmed that you fell out of the sky like Spider-Man, or did they realize that you're like a gang leader?
Well, I think you're in trouble, your friend.
Yeah, I seem to have screwed the pooch.
Hey, let's see how good of an assassin you really are.
Oh, my goodness, there's so many dudes.
Well, they're attacking you multiple times now and shooting you and stuff. Oh, that was violent.
Oh, you failed that side.
Yeah.
Let me be totally honest with you. Despite all the reason we say Assassin's Creed is still lacking, I still really want to play this game.
Yeah.
No, I mean it's definitely fun. It's just like every time I play an Assassin's Creed game, I still have fun. But it just reminds me of like how good they could truly be.
Mm-hmm. You were probably, telling me earlier that this is
die.
The best one you've played since Black Flag. So that that alone just gets me excited to play it. It's because I love that game so much. I know a lot of people didn't, but I really liked it.
I think it's pretty, you know, a pretty clear consistency that,
I mean, just as far as, like, the original games were, like, pretty much the first three are, like, the best three, if you ask most people who play these games.
Yeah.
Well, I've never heard one person say the first one was his favorite.
Well, it's just that, like...
Actually, Zach Bynum's favorite one of all time is the first one.
That's one of the worst ones, for sure.
I get why he likes that one. He said his favorite part about that game is specifically just the story. He thought it was cool how the Order of the Assassins was very similar to, like, the Jedi Knights.
Yeah.
You know how Zach is about Jedi, so... I mean, you know how we all are about Jedis, but Zach thought the Assassins, I don't know what you call them, their guild or whatever, was very similar to the Jedi Order in the first game.
Yeah.
That's what attracted to him, attracted the game to him in the first place, which I get. But yeah, gameplay wise, it was definitely lacking compared to the
very
sequels.
Repetitive.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Zach is probably what originally got me into this series. And it's weird that I still play it and he doesn't. How things change.
Gotta escape. Yes. One thing, if you're fighting dudes that are higher level than you, they'll just break your combo and they will give you no chance to counter it.
Hey, one thing Unity did right that's carried over to this game is that these cops can't cheat. Wait, is this guy in the rooftop?
Oh, yeah.
How do you get up there?
Wow. Because they can all of a sudden free run again.
Oh, what? That was the best part about Unity is that they couldn't chase you up rooftops.
Yep.
What?
You're literally just like, that is so cool. And
that is so dumb. Here, what's the point of having your cool grappling hook getting away like a badass and they're just like leaping up the building like the Hulk?
I know. I thought we were done with that, but
that is ridiculous. It's like, what's the point of running? Just kill all of them.
Cheeky.
So he's just gonna chill up here now.
That looks like a good guy. Oh, he shot the poor man in
the
face.
Oh, he's a civilian?
Yeah, he was your buddy. Okay, he's probably one of those guys who's like,
what
hey, I'll
he
help
doing
you.
Up there?
Well, I know, what was he doing?
Okay, I don't think the cops chased you up there. I think they kept it from Unity. Oh, man, that's
horses
violent.
Are going crazy.
Yeah, that guy could only follow you up there because he's one of those guys that can follow you. Yeah.
I have had
one of your pals.
I have had guys chase me up on buildings.
Oh, that sucks.
Yeah, the blighters.
That's unfortunate.
Me. Yeah. Because I thought exactly that. I just skadoodled up there. Oh, there's
I guess with the addition of the grappling
hook.
There's
Ricky Dickens.
Name, yeah. What makes you so sure
I want something? I guess with the addition of the grappling hook, they thought it'd be almost too easy to get away now if people don't chase you.
Maybe.
Because it's one thing to have to climb up and it takes time and they can like shoot at you and stuff, but if you have a grappling hook, you're out of there in like 2 seconds.
Yeah.
Granted, you'd think that over all the centuries of the assassins, they finally progressed to have a grappling hook to get away easier. That way, like, wow, we don't have to worry about people shooting us when we climb buildings anymore. We can just get away quicker.
Yeah.
But, I don't know. In the sense of the lore, that would make more sense to me, but I guess for the sake of gameplay, they're like, it has to be a little more challenging.
Yeah.
So there is a Templar presence in this game, right?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
All the enemy gang, the leaders and stuff, they're Templars. Right. And then there's a guy that's, like, you know, ultimately in control of the entire city. He's a big Templar dude.
It's the same old story.
So remind me, it's been so long since I've known what even the goal of the Templars are. Is it simply just for, like, world control or something?
Yeah, they want the pieces of Eden to, like, control the world, I think.
Yeah.
I think that's really cool. You can jump on and off moving trains. I'm into that. Obviously, it's nothing new, because you can do that in Spider-Man 2 on PS2, and I was always fascinated by that. But, it's still cool, nonetheless, doing it in Victorian London.
Yeah. You also have a train as your
home base.
Your home base.
Yeah, that's very cool. I thought that was awesome.
Personally, that was one of the things I liked about Unity, was that little house.
Yeah.
You had, like, your headquarters, and you go up to the top, check out all your uniforms.
Well, in Assassin's Creed 2, you had your own, like, town.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah. The villa.
Well, forgive me, but I didn't start playing until 3.
That's okay.
What did you have in 3?
You had a whole, like, plantation.
Oh, yeah, you had that house. Yeah. That was
cool. Oh, yeah, I forgot about that.
And you had, like,
I
liked
Assassin's
Creed.
I loved the combat in Assassin's Creed 3.
Yeah, Assassin's Creed 3 combat was freaking awesome.
The story,
it didn't
not
feel
so
as,
much.
It didn't feel as shoddy as...
No, and more often than not, two dudes would attack you at once, and you get those cool animations where you take them out with both.
Yeah.
And that tomahawk was so fun to use, too. It just felt so brutal. And I loved the bow and arrow in that game, too, even though that was before they were... Were you able to free aim with the bow and arrow in 3, or was that still before you could free aim? I don't think they brought in free aiming to Black Flag, if I'm not mistaken.
Was there a bow and arrow in Black Flag? I don't feel like
there was a blow dart. Yeah. I mean, that one was really fun. I loved Black Flag.
This guy's giving you a run for your money, level 6. Combo 12.
I wish they'd fall off the train when you punch them. That'd be so cool.
I mean, I just did an did you see the animation where, like, Sparta kicked him off?
Yeah.
Maybe if you were paying attention, you would have saw.
But just naturally, physically, too, if they died,
they typically
it'd be cool.
Would. Like, I don't know, he was probably just at the right area for him to not do that.
So what did you just do?
I detached.
Because it didn't look like you did anything.
I'm amazed that top hat stays on his head doing all this running around and fighting. He probably super glues it to his head every time.
I'm sure that's what he
does. Or velcros it to his hair.
That's what the English do, I've heard.
Oh. Yeah, I still think the top hat is kind of silly. It just seems like they're just trying to stereotype.
You just stabbed that man in the neck and he wasn't dead yet.
Yeah. because the main villain like has his tea and stuff. It's like they're trying like super hard to be like British.
I will say his gauntlet he has for his hidden blade looks really cool.
It does. Yeah.
What's that he has on the top of it?
Well,
is it the grappling hook, I'm assuming?
Yes.
Okay.
So I'm guessing there's no, like, little mini arrow gun on his gauntlet like there was in Unity?
Arrow gun. Oh, no, the Phantom Blade?
Yeah, the Phantom Blade. That was, like, Unity's thing. I like that. Every Kree kind of has its little assassin ability that you need to it.
The worst one, definitely in my opinion, was Revelation.
What was in Revelation?
Like, the hook blade.
The hook blade. Yeah. What did that do?
You could, like, attach to ropes and, like, swing down it. That was
That's it?
Yeah, that was literally it.
So stupid.
It was not that cool. Defend. Holy crap, Ned,
oh,
you're
gosh.
So far away.
Who's Ned?
I don't know.
Why do you have to go back there?
Oh, defend Ned. Just jumping off.
I think you're gonna fail.
Hang on, Ned. What the heck? I didn't. It said keep detaching stuff. My bad.
Spoiler alert, by the way, Revelations ends with Ezio literally sitting down in a chair in a tomb and just dying, right?
That was Altair.
Was it?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Because Ezio went and found his bones.
That's right. That's right. Yeah. But didn't Ezio end up staying in there too, or no?
I don't think so. Okay. I have literally no
idea. Oh, that's who it was. I remember because he discovers it and you're like, wow, Altair was just totally badass and just sat down in his throne and died in it.
Yeah.
It's pretty cool.
He plays him as like an old man.
Yeah.
So what happened to Ezio?
I would like for them to go to the Middle Eastern age again.
That'd be so cool. Imagine like an Aladdin type assassin.
That'd be cool.
That'd be kind of cool.
Let's just do Aladdin.
The street rat
assassin.
What if
there's just an Aladdin
game? I feel
like
that rumor.
I would love that.
Of Egyptian Assassin's Creed.
Yeah.
Sounds awesome. Like
imagine
like
if
slaves
and
stuff, like freeing them and everything.
Imagine if like there's a twist on Moses' story and he was an assassin.
That would be kind of
be kind
of
cool. Had a,
and Pharaoh was a Templar.
That would be
like
kind of cool.
Splitting the Red
Sea. Yeah. What? Like I'm off. I mean, I don't want to obviously botch the true story of Moses, but imagine if his staff had a piece of Eden on, and that's how he was just parting the Red Sea and stuff.
Awesome.
That'd be gnarly.
Holy crap. I have to redo all of this.
Uh-oh.
Well, let's try it. Let's give it one more go. This time we'll protect Ned, whoever
well,
that
give
is.
Give it a wave.
Well.
Give it a wave. I'm assuming you guys heard, speaking of Harry Potter, about the cursed child.
Yeah.
The play that's coming out. It kind of makes me sad that she's not just writing a book. Maybe a book form will come out later, and that would be a big surprise.
I hope there's
cool.
a way that I can watch it.
Right,
or, like,
yeah.
see it, because
maybe they'll
she's
record
only
it.
Doing shows in
London.
So.
Dude, how cool would it be if you could afford to not only fly to England, but go to that play and see it? Are they going to use the cast from the movie to do the play? I feel like that'd be in their best interest. Why would they not do that?
I mean, it's going to be about his...
Like, I know it's a play, but a lot of actors act in plays.
I mean, the
regular.
Story is
like,
specifically about his son.
Right. I mean, Daniel Radcliffe has done plays before.
Right.
So.
Yeah. Ooh.
That was cool.
That was cool.
I don't really think there's been a lot of information about what's actually happening. Just that it's happening. And that it's a play.
That would be so cool if it's the new book called Harry Potter and the Cursed Child. That sounds awesome.
That's what I'm hoping.
That would be so cool. And I thought, I only read a small synopsis about it. I didn't read too much into it, but it basically said like his son is inheriting a legacy that he never wanted and stuff, blah, blah, blah.
Yeah. Well, Harry never wanted it either.
Right. So deal with it, son.
Deal with it, we're Potters.
You're the heir to the Potter throne.
Preston, you are being so brutal.
I'm sorry. I don't understand what the reinforcement wagons are to detach them. I don't understand.
It doesn't look like he does either. He just opens it up and shuts it. It's like, well, nothing to see here.
I guess that's just like a side objective, so I'm like not even going to bother with it right now.
So why did... Oh, he did take out both. Okay. He does the same thing every time. Here we go.
I think I have it. Do I have it?
Yep.
Attach the reinforcement point.
Attach the cargo wagon. Okay.
Detach.
So this... So I don't think you get on that one.
Yeah, is he punching that till it broke?
Yeah, that's how sick he is.
Yeah, now you're supposed to go back. Alright, here's where you messed up last time.
I have to defend? There's like 80 guys on here.
Who's this guy again you're defending? Ned?
This is Ned.
Is it Ned Stark?
Yeah, probably.
Okay, it looks just
kinda
like
looks
him.
Like no way.
I don't know. This is the, this is actually a woman.
Is it really?
Yeah.
Oh, wow, okay.
Yeah, so I,
that's
this
a
is,
woman?
Yeah. That's okay. The transgender character they have.
Oh, that's exciting.
Yeah. So, is it a guy or a woman?
It's a woman being a guy, I'm pretty sure.
Okay.
It's a big brute you're fighting here.
And your skill points.
Oh, you're just mashing square.
Yep. It's like the extent of it.
That seems really fun. It was a little claustrophobic
there. That was
there.
All you had
that
to
was
do.
It.
Wow.
Apparently, 8 guys couldn't do that.
Wow.
That was a great design there, Ubi.
Ubisoft. So what was your goal of defending Ned here? What cargo are you trying to acquire? Granted, it probably said it in a cutscene while we weren't even paying attention to talking about Harry
Potter
and Moses.
I guess
Jesus
right here.
Maybe it's the light bulb.
The internal combustion transport. Engine. So a motor.
Oh, that's cool.
Car.
Imagine if you could upgrade to a motorized
like a
vehicle
hot rod
at the end.
Maybe you'll be responsible for the first car in London. You're giving
them to your maybe you'll give the blueprints to Henry Ford at the end of the game.
Well, Ned here has, like, an American accent.
How long have you been working
okay.
with
mm.
She's a business partner.
So maybe he sells it to Ford.
Maybe.
That's how history happened.
What does Patrick say? He-she-me-wombo. What does he say?
I think that's it.
He-she-me-wombo. Come on, SpongeBob.
That's hilarious.
Aren't they like arguing that wombo is not a word or something?
I can't remember. He's like, everyone knows about wombo.
Did you turn it to Tawombo?
Oh. It's Mermaid Man's belt, isn't it?
It's on M. You switch it to wombo.
That's so funny.
He turns it to a W.
Wombo.
That's so funny.
I love SpongeBob.
Well, this is certainly an excellent stopping point. I was going to wait and see if there's any more cutscenes after this.
I don't think so.
Oh, here we go.
We're on a train.
Is that your train?
It's a very pretty gold one.
Yes. Yep, it is my train.
Nice.
This is Agnes talking. She's the conductor of this choo-choo.
That's cool.
I think her name is Agnes. Her last name is hilarious. It's like Agnes McBean or something.
McBean, huh?
McBean Cup or
sounds
something.
Great.
It's like something.
Agnes.
Agnes McBean Cup.
Wow.
Wish my name was Agnes. JK.
Jacob Agnes.
Yeah. Jacob Angus.
Stanky Ringus. I still wish that was your gamer tag. That's the greatest thing ever.
I should have done that. I don't know if it happened.
Well, cool,
I don't know if that's enough characters, though.
Yeah, zebra.
That. Oh, that's cool. Is that is that a gazelle that was next to it? It looked like a gazelle.
I got a new cane. I think
a cane.
Yep, a cane. And I'm not a high
Sir LeMaze.
Looks pretty cool.
Mr. Nice. LeMaze.
Well, boys, it was truly an honor, as always, diving into this gentleman's game. Assassin's Creed based in London is truly a gentleman's game.
I enjoyed watching you play.
We should have been sipping bourbon and smoking cigars this whole time.
Yes.
I do like both of those things.
Yeah, it's great time for sure with the gentleman when that happens. But
yes.
Ladies and gentlemen, to you, to all of you, thank you so much for joining us for Assassin's Creed Syndicate for the second time. We hope you enjoyed our commentary and the gameplay this evening. If you enjoy our commentary, we do a podcast every single week. You can join us for that. Comment there. We can have a discussion. We love talking to our viewers. Even though the comments are few and far between, we'd love to grow that and talk to you guys more because we really want to build a community with you guys. I know everyone says that, but we mean that from the bottom of our hearts, and this channel can do that. We believe in that.
Every comment matters, in my opinion.
It really does. We get so pumped about it, so keep those coming. And please like this video if you enjoyed it. Subscribe for more. As always, my name's Garrett. This is Jacob. That's Preston. We'll be seeing you again very soon.
See you guys.